Hi, I'm Gemma Gould. I'm a digital illustrator and designer from the UK. In this short tutorial, I'm going to show you a few keyboard shortcuts to use when creating digital illustrations in Photoshop.
In Adobe Photoshop, there are hundreds of tools and features at our disposal. If there are tools or functions which we use often in our work, we can save a lot of time by memorizing the keyboard shortcuts for them. First, I'll open a new document by pressing Ctrl and N on a Windows PC, or Command and N on a Mac. I can also open an existing document by pressing Ctrl or Command and O. And we can now cycle between these open documents by pressing Ctrl or Command and Tab. If we wanted to turn the rulers on or off, we can do so by pressing Ctrl or Command and R. And now we can drag guides onto our artwork. By pressing Z, we can access the zoom tool to help us view our artwork in more detail. We click to zoom in, and to zoom out, we simply press Alt for a Windows PC or Option for Mac. We can also move around the document by holding down the space bar and dragging. I'll create a new layer by pressing Ctrl or Command, Shift and N, and give this layer a name. And press Enter or OK. We can access the Lasso Selection tool by pressing L, which lets us select areas to paint or to adjust. We can fill this selection with the foreground color by pressing Alt or Option and Delete. And to deselect the selection, we press Ctrl or Command and D. We can access the Eraser tool by pressing E. I can press Ctrl or Command and T for the Transform tool. Now I'm going to start painting, so I'll press B to access the Brush tool. I only want to paint within this shape, so I can lock the transparent pixels of this layer by pressing the / key. I can toggle between my background and foreground colours by pressing X. By right-clicking with the brush tool selected, I can change the brush. If we hold the Alt key while using a Windows PC, or the Option key while using a Mac, we can select different colours very quickly with the eyedropper tool. Now I'm going to adjust the colours, so I'll press Ctrl or Command and U to access the Hue and Saturation window. I can change the brush size by using the square brackets. And I can alter the brush opacity by pressing one of the numbers at the top from 1 to 0, 1 being 10% opacity and 0 being 100% opacity. We can also type two numbers in quick succession to get more specific percentages. For example, 3, 6 gives 36% opacity. To undo, I can press Ctrl and Z or Command and Z. And to redo, I press Ctrl or Command Shift and Z. To fit the document onto the screen again, we can press Ctrl or Command and 0. And once we are ready to save our work, we save by pressing Ctrl or Command and S.
I really hope you've enjoyed these tips. If you've enjoyed this content, then please subscribe to this channel. If you'd like to learn more with me, I invite you to join my course. The link is in the description to this video.